Right now, live in the studio is Senator Roger Wicker to talk about the story you just heard from Craig and also some other issues. Senator, real quick, the super committee failed yesterday. A lot of Americans are really upset that it seems as if Congress or lawmakers, federal lawmakers, can't compromise on some very critical issues.
Well, I'm very disappointed. It's a missed opportunity for spending reduction. But if we could look on the bright side, and there's not much of a bright side, the debate has turned in Washington. We've had several months now of intense discussion on how to reduce the deficit. In years past, it was always a debate about how can we spend more money, how can we have more stimulus spending, more programs. So the conversation has changed to debt reduction, and although we missed this opportunity, I think we'll continue to debate how to save money from now on.
With all due respect, they had several weeks to come up with some type of compromise, but still nothing was done. And some Americans are so upset, they're even saying, let's vote them out of office. Are you hearing that in Washington as well?
Oh, I think that's the reason we have elections, no question about it. And you know, the bad thing about it is we've had bipartisan committees that did come up with solutions. The so-called group of six in the Senate, three Democrats and three Republicans, came forward with a recommendation, liberals and conservatives alike, the Bowles-Simpson Commission. So I'm disappointed. I'm sorry the president is involved in the blame game. The fact is,
Everyone is.
He was absent from Washington for the last week, and I think Mayor Bloomberg yesterday was correct. With some presidential leadership, we probably could have gotten.
Should he have
done.
Been on that super committee, you think?
No, I think he should have been helping the super committee come to a compromise, and I think it was well within our reach. Disappointed that this didn't happen.
Mm-hmm. Well, the world is with uncertainty. Are you worried that the markets will start to react with nervousness when they see that, you know, United States, our federal lawmakers just can't seem to work together, especially with what's happening in Europe?
I think the markets were sort of ready for this, but I tell you, the world is watching, and we're seeing what happened in Europe when they couldn't come to grips with spending. We have a spending problem in the United States of America, and if we want to avoid being Europe in a year or two, we need to learn from the lesson there, because they are suffering the consequences that we will have unless we correct this spending problem we have.
Okay, I want to move on to Grover Norquist. He, of course, is the head of the Americans for Tax Reform. He seems, well, a lot of people are saying, a lot of political pundits are saying, that he has made the Republican Party one of their mainstay or issues is preventing tax hikes. And he also came up with a pledge, I believe. And a lot of people on Capitol Hill have signed that pledge. I believe all of the Republican presidential hopefuls have signed it except John Huntsman. But there's talk that a lot of senators signed that pledge. Did you sign that for preventing no tax hikes regardless?
I didn't sign it the last election, but I certainly agree with that. But, you know, the president has said the same thing. He said, during a recession, we don't need to raise taxes. That was Barack Obama. Mm-hmm. I think he's changed his mind in the last couple of months. But I think President Obama was correct when he said that. We're in a situation where we have a recession, where people are reluctant to create jobs. When we go to a small business person and say we want more tax money, that's money that cannot be used to create jobs in the private sector.
Okay, I know, real quick, I know you did not want to endorse anyone for the Republican nomination for president, but who do you think has the best chance of beating Obama?
Well, there are various polls, but let me say this. For the first time, Mississippians may get to make a difference. We're going to have a presidential primary second Tuesday in March, and it may be that it will not be decided, and Mississippi's primary could actually make a difference. So I'm not endorsing anybody, but I sure hope a lot of people go out and register their preferences second Tuesday of March.
All right, thank you so much. Senator Roger Wicker joining us live in the studio. Back to you, Craig.